QuickQ version 11 stable is now available for download with some great new features. One of them being MIDI output. Here you can see I've got two QuickQ 20 consoles. On the QuickQ 20 and 30 consoles, they both have MIDI output ports as well as inputs. What we can now do is we can use the MIDI out from one console to go into another to do things like synchronizing the playbacks. You could be running different shows, but you can synchronize the playback state. So very simply, there's no setting involved in it. Taking a 5-pin MIDI cable from the out of one to the input another, exactly like I've got so here. When I run a playback up on our 10 playbacks, it doesn't sync the cue faders on the left-hand side, but on the main faders here, when I run a playback up here, it will sync to this one here. You can see it takes the level and it's activating this playback. It could be a different cue stack running a different show. It's just sending the playback state, so activating playback one or the level of playback one. It will also send things like the cue information. So if I go to a cue on a playback, this will be sent as well. You can find in the QuickQ manual the full list of commands supported when we're sending this, but it's very simple. It's just sending out a MIDI note and a velocity message for the playback and to give you the cue ID. Again, you can find full details of the notes that it sends in the QuickQ manual. This is also supported when using genetics devices. If I go into my net devices window on the console over here, you can see here it sees my GN5, which I have connected to the console via network. And there's a simple toggle switch to allow send and receive via MIDI. Our genetics GN5 and GN10 nodes have MIDI in and out ports on them. When you network to a QuickQ console, you can either send and receive, once you've toggled this options on, MIDI notes from the console or to the console. So this would allow me to say have a GN5 locally on stage, and I can be sending MIDI messages into it, which the console receives. And also when I'm running the playback, so I toggle that option on, it can be sending the MIDI note messages out from the GN5, which could be elsewhere in the venue. Using MIDI output is not just for syncing up to another QuickQ console. You can also use that for third-party integration with other bits of software. When I activate this playback, it could do another function in your software, activate a video or something that you've got set to trigger there. Also in our QuickQ V11 release, we've added the ability to set custom images on the home screen. If I drop onto the home screen here, you can see I've set an image background of my stage where I can now line up the fixtures to match my lighting plot. So if I unlock the window, you can see I've added in a truss here of my spots. I can drag those into this window and over where the fixture is. To set the image, all I need to do is first unlock the layout view, which is how you'd normally drag and move your fixtures around in this window. And you'll see there's a new image button at the top here. I click the image button. If you want to clear the current background image you've got, clear background will just take you back to a normal gray background. And if I then hit set background, you can go and pick an image file. I'm at the moment remoting the console over network, which allows me to actually go in to my documents folder, and I can go and choose an image file that I might have somewhere else on the PC. So maybe instead of the plot, I want to use a logo, my logo or something. And you can see I've now set that as the background image. In version 11, we've also added studio color mixing and studio mode for the console. You'll find these options in the settings window. So if I go down to settings and go to show, you can see you've got three options for color control. You've got use RGB emitters, use all emitters, or studio color mixing. This is only changing how the color picker works. So if we go, I've set here studio color mixing. If I go to my home window, I select some fixtures, let's say the pars here, select some of those, and I go to color, all it's changing is how my color picker here interacts and works. So if I use just RGB, maybe my fixture, it's an LED par maybe, has got red, green, blue, amber, lime or something in that fixture. If I'm in RGB mode, would only use the red, green, blue emitters. It would ignore, the, say, the amber and lime. If I say use all emitters, it will do what it says in the tin, use all the emitters to mix a color. So when I use set hit for green here, would use the relevant emitters. It would start using, say, the lime emitter to mix that color as well. The third option which I've set is our studio color mixing mode, which adds some even further control to color. This is ideally suited to studios, the name. Maybe it's a small broadcast style studio, or maybe even a theatrical environment. As you can see here, you can change the view from the usual color picker ball to a CIE chart here. And there's a couple of different views in this window. If we come across to the right-hand side here, we can change our color space. And we give you four different selectable color spaces. What I get inside in my CIE chart here is I get two triangles. I get a triangle with a black line, which shows me the color space. And then in the lighter color, it shows me what the fixture is actually capable of rendering. So if I was to click outside here, both the color space and the fixture can't render the color here. Where you see an exclamation mark here is telling me that the fixture is missing color data. It doesn't have color data in the head file. We've been working very hard to add color data to our ChamSys head library, but be aware if you see this sign here, this is telling us that we're actually having to approximate the data because the emitter data doesn't exist on the console. But for the main manufacturers, this now exists in the console. We also have the ability to set things like color temperature. So I can set a white point and set my base color temperature. Up in the top right now, we also have the ability to set colors based on RGB values or using the hex value here. So if you're trying to match a color, maybe it's a brand color or something, you can use the RGB filters here or enter the hex color here to pick a color. Studio color mixing mode actually changes the operation of a console, and you'll find this in the settings window under your options here, where you have live mode and theater mode, which pre-existed already. You have a new studio mode. Studio mode changes how the console works. Be careful if you've got an existing show. It simplifies the console. It's designed for a small studio that's just going to run 10 playbacks. If I was to turn on studio mode, you'll see that all of my stacks of multiple cues will be changed to single cues. It does give you a warning before you do this. If you are going to change this in an existing show, please save a show before you do this. And when you're in studio mode, you can see it's locked to single cues only. And it changes my home screen. It gives me things like an intensity control on the left-hand side of the screen as well for the selected fixtures. You can find more information about studio mode inside our manual. Also in QuickQ version 11, we've added function types. You'll see on the home screen here, I've patched in a Showa Professional Color Strike M fixture. If you're not familiar with this is a strobe fixture, which has got a strobe in the middle and color plates around the outside of it. In previous versions, it was difficult to control individually these parts, as to say the color control section, the plates around the edge, or the strobe in the middle. Another example could be things like on the DJ end, the Showa DJ Gig Bar, which has got some moving heads, some pars, some derbies, a laser on top of it. Now when you patch these sort of fixtures, we give you an option in the home screen, as you can see here, for selecting these parts individually. So I can take the color plates of my strobe, or the beam part, the actual strobe part. If it was in my gig bar, it would give me the individual parts to select. This happens automatically now in our V11 release. And finally, one of the other great features in V11 is audio and beat detection. On a console, if you go up to the audio input at the top here, you can see you now have much better detection of beat, and it gives you your beat graph there, showing you the incoming BPM. And if I've set chases to audio input, the algorithm now used for beat detection has been much improved. There's more enhancements to a QuickQ V11, which you can find in our change notes, which you can view in the link below on this video here. Please download QuickQ V11 now. We'd love to hear your comments and feedback on V11, so please do comment in here on the YouTube channel as well. We love reading your comments and feedback and suggestions. So download QuickQ V11 now from the ChamSys website.